Welcome to KubeCon 2024. We're here in Paris with Erin. Hi, Erin. Welcome to KubeCon.
Hi, Rohan. Nice to meet you.
So, Erin, in these times of rapid developments in technology, especially AI, has open source lost its meaning?
Oh, I hope open source has not lost the appeal and what it means. I think with the advent of AI into the ecosystem, if you came to day one keynotes, you know, every single keynote, you know, either mentioned a GPU or an AI workload. But there really is something fundamental about keeping that open. And, you know, today with Hugging Face and all the models that are hosted, it's really hard to see unless you're an expert in open source licensing to understand whether or not that's open. But really, it's critical to having the transparency that we expect in open source, as well as the provenance of the data and protecting privacy of users, that we continue as a community to push to make many of these concepts and technologies open.
And what about Red Hats and Red Hat OpenShift and just our technologies in the open source communities and working with those communities? Can you tell us a little bit more about that?
Yeah, sure. So OpenShift AI originally started off with a project called Open Data Hub, which is still an open source project intended to really drive the ecosystem as far as AI technologies go, also very data focused. And so, you know, at Red Hat, I work in emerging technologies. So we're kind of looking at the total spectrum of what the ecosystem needs to enable. And with AI, it's really, you know, more than just enablement in Kubernetes to change a couple labels to, you know, enable the GPUs or change the CRD. It really is all the way down to the hardware. So if we talk about GPUs, you know, we need to consider, as we've heard many times this week, there is a supply chain shortage. It's very hard to get GPUs. And what can we do, both from responsible computing to technology, to be able to offset that? So one of the things that we're working at in emerging technologies really is looking at AI at the edge. And the edge can really be defined as close edge. You know, it's a server outside of my data center that might be, you know, in a remote location, or it could be the far edge. It could be, you know, on a telco tower somewhere. And so I think what I see happening in the next 18 months and beyond around AI is that we'll do more computing, more data aggregation where it's happening, and we'll use federated learning to pull all that data together to keep people's information private. What that does is it enables us to run these inference applications on different things besides GPUs. You know, a lot of these applications already are being tuned to be able to run on CPUs. So I know today it's all about LLMs. Tomorrow it's going to be about RAG, but I really see in the future it's actually going to be about minimizing and small models that can run on the edge.
Thanks so much for taking the time to speak to us, Erin.
Thank you for having me.